Lord. Good morning, my beloved. Thank you for your presence here today, those following on the live stream, as we gather to offer our prayers for the servant of God, Penelope Dimitriadis. You will also hear the name in Greek, Parthena, which was Parthenope, but Parthena was her baptismal name. This is the name that she always used when she received Holy Communion. So we'll say both names, Parthena and Penelope, Penelope. Let us listen to the 23rd Psalm from the Old Testament. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness. For his name's sake, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Would you please rise? May God be merciful unto me, O Theos, elasti timito amartolo. O God, be gracious unto us and have mercy upon us. Ευλογητός ο Θεός ημών πάντοτε νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Blessed is our God, always, now and ever. And on to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Αμωμή εν οδό, αλληλούια. Ευλογητός η Κύριε διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου. Αλληλούια.
My soul is worn with endless longing for your judgment at all times. Alleluia.
My soul has slumbered from sorrow. Strengthen me with your words. Alleluia.
Incline my heart unto your testimonies and not unto covetousness. Alleluia.
I am a partaker of all that fear you and with them that keep your commandments. Alleluia.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia.
Ελέησον ημάς ο Θεός κατά το μέγα έλεος σου, Θεόμεθά σου επάκουσον και ελέησον.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray for the repose of the soul of the servant of God, Penelope Parthena, departed this life, for the forgiveness of her every transgression, voluntary and involuntary.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Όπως Κύριος ο Θεός τα ψυχήν αυτής, εν θα ειδίκαι αναπαύονται τα ελέη του Θεού την Βασιλεία των Ουρανών και άφησε των αυτής αμαρτιών παρά Χριστό του αθανάτου, Βασιλεί και Θεό ημών ετισόμεθα.
Κύριε λέησον, Κύριε λέησον, Κύριε λέησον.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For you are the resurrection, the life, and the repose of your servant Penelope, But then, O Christ, our God, and unto you we give glory, with your eternal Father and your all holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
You can be seated. Εχείρε σου επίσαν με και πλάσαν με, συνέτησό με και μαθήσω με τα σέντολά σου, ελέησόν με, Κύριε.
For I have become as a bottle in the frost, yet your statutes have I not forgotten. Have mercy on me, O Lord.
I am yours, O save me, for after your statutes have I sought. Have mercy on me, O Lord.
From your judgments I have not declined, for you have set a law for me. Have mercy on me, O Lord.
Έκλεινα την καρδία μου του πείσε τα δικαιώματά σου εις των αιώνων διανταμεύσιν. Ελέησον με, Κύριε.
It is time to serve the Lord, but they have violated your law. Have mercy on me, O Lord.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιώ και Αγίω Πνεύματι και νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Ελέησον με, Κύριε, Κύριε, και ελέησον με, Αλληλούια, επίβλαψον επέ με, και ελέησον με κατά το κρίμα των αγαπώντων το όνομά σου, Αλληλούια. I am
yours and accounted as nothing. Your statutes I have not forgotten. Hear my voice, O Lord, according to your mercy, according to your judgments. Quicken me. Alleluia.
Princes have persecuted me without a cause, and because of your words my heart has been afraid. Alleluia.
My soul shall live and shall praise you, and your judgments will help me. Alleluia.
Επλανήθην ως πρόβατον απολωλών ζήτησον την δούλην σου, ότι τα σέντολά σου και πελανθόμοι. Ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου, τον Αγίον ο χορός έβρε πηγή της ζωής και θύραν παραδείσου, ευρωκαγώ την οδόν διά της μετανοίας, το απόλολος πρόβατον εγώ ημί, ανακάλεσέ με, σωτήρ και σώσον με.
Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your statutes. You who of old did fashion me out of nothingness, and with your image divine did honor me, but because of transgressions of your commandments did return me again to the earth where I was taken. Lead me back to your and refashion me into that ancient beauty of your likeness.
Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your statutes. I am an image of your unutterable glory, though I bear the scars of my stumblings. Have compassion on me, the work of your hands, O sovereign Lord, and cleanse me through your loving kindness. And the homelet of my heart's desire bestow on me by making me a citizen of paradise.
Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your statutes. Give rest, O God, upon your servant, and appoint for her a place in paradise, where the choirs of the saints, O Lord, and the just will shine forth like stars. To your servant that is sleeping now, do you give rest, overlooking all of her offenses.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιώ και Αγίω Πνεύματι, το τρισλαμπές της μιας θεότητος, ευσεβώς υμνήσομεν βόντες, Άγιος Υ, ο Πατήρ ο Άναρχος, ο Συνάναρχος Υιός και Θείον Πνεύμα, φώτισον ημάς πίστης ηλατρεύοντας και του αιωνίου πυρός εξάρπασον.
Both now and ever and to the ages of ages. Amen. Hail, O gracious Lady, that in the flesh bears God for the salvation of all, and through whom the human race has found salvation. Through you may we find paradise. Theotokos, Our Lady, pure and blessed.
Alleluia, 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 doxa si o Theo.
Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God.
Alleluia, 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 doxa si o Theo. With the saints give rest, O Christ, to the soul of your servant, where there is no pain nor any sorrow, nor any sigh, but life everlasting. Μετά των Αγίων ανάπαυσο Χριστέ, την ψυχή της δούλη σου έμθα ουκέστη πόνος που λείπει που στεναγμός αλλά ζωή Please be seated. Where's the pleasure in life which is unmixed with sorrow? Where's the glory which on earth has stood firm and unchanged? All things are weaker than shadow, all are more elusive than dreams. Comes one fell stroke, and death in turn prevails over all these vanities. Wherefore, in the light, O Christ, of your countenance, and in the sweetness of your beauty, to her whom you have chosen, grant repose, for you are the friend of mankind.
Like a blossom that wastes away, and like a dream that passes and is gone, so is every mortal into dust resolved. But again, when the trumpet sounds its call, as though a quaking of the earth, all the dead shall arise and go forth to meet you, O Christ our God. And on that day, O Lord, for her who you have withdrawn from among us, appoint a place of attending of your saints, yea, for the spirit of your servant, O Christ.
Vanity are all the works and quests of men. Πάντα ματαιώτιστα ανθρωπινά όσα ουχ υπάρχει μετά θάνατον, ου παραμένει ο πλούτος, ου συνοδεύει δόξα, απελθόν γαρο θάνατος, ταυτά πάντα εξυφάνιστε, διό Χριστό το αθανάτο βασίλη βοήσομε, την μεταστάσαν εξ ημών ανάπαυσον, εν θα πάντων εστίν εφρενωμένον η κατοικία.
Where is now our affection for earthly things? Where is now the alluring pomp of transient questioning? Where is now our gold and our silver? Where is now the surging crowd of domestics and their busy cries? All is dust, all is ashes, all is shadow. Wherefore, draw near, that we may cry out into our immortal King and Lord, your everlasting blessing vouchsafe unto her that now has gone away, and bring her to repose in that blessedness which never grows old.
I call to mind the prophet who shouted, I am but earth and ash. And once again I looked with attention on the tombs, and I saw the bones therein which of flesh were naked, and I said, which indeed is he that is king, or which is the soldier, which is the wealthy, which is the needy, which the righteous, or which the sinner? But to your servant, O Lord, grant that she, that with the righteous she may repose.
My beginning and foundation was the foremost bestowing word of your commandment, for it pleased you to make me, by compounding visible and invisible nature into a living thing. Out of earth was my body formed and made, but a soul you gave me by the divine and life-creating in-breathing. Wherefore, O Christ, to your servant be, to your servant in the land of the living, in the courts of the righteous, do you grant repose.
Ανάπαυσον σωτήριμον ζωδότα, ημετέστησας αδελφήν ημών, εκ των προσκαίρων κράζοντα δόξαση.
When in your own image and likeness you, in the beginning, did create and fashion man, you gave him a home in paradise, and you made him the chief among your creations. But by the devil's envy, alas, beguiled to eat the forbidden fruit, transgressor then of your commandments he became. Wherefore, back to earth, and from which he was first taken, you did sentence him to return again, O Lord, and to pray to you, to you, Lord, to give him rest, give her rest.
Θρηνώ και οδύρωμαι όταν εννοήσω τον θάνατον και είδον εν της τάφης κειμένη την κατοικώνα Θεού πλαστησαν ημίν ωραιότητα αμορφων άδοξο μη έχουσαν είδος ο του θαύματος τι το περίμα του των γέγονε μυστήριον πως παρεδόθη με τη φθορά και συνεζεύθη με το θανάτο. Όντως Θεού προστάξιος γεγράπτε, Θεού παρέχοντος τη μεταστάση την ανάπαυση.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The death which you have endured, O Lord, is become the harbinger of deathlessness. If you had not been laid in your tomb, then would not the gates of paradise have been opened? Wherefore, to her now gone from us, give rest, for you are the friend of mankind.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιώ και Αγίω Πνεύματι, και νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων, αμήν. Αγνή Παρθένε του Λόγου πύλη, του Θεού ημών μύτην οικέτευε, ελεηθήν εν την ψυχήν αυτής. Remember us, O Lord, when you come into your kingdom. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted.
Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth.
Blessed are they who hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled.
Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy.
Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God.
Μακάρι ειρηνοποιεί ότι αυτοί Θεού, τέκνα Θεού κληθήσονται.
Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Blessed are you when men shall revile you and persecute you and say all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake.
Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven.
Please rise. Μακάρι αιώδος υπορεύει σήμερον ότι τιμάστησι όπως αναπαυσεώς. Blessed is the way wherein you walk today, for there is prepared for you a place of eternal rest. Μακάρι αιώδος υπορεύει σήμερον ότι ετοιμάστησι τόπος αναπαυσεώς. Please be seated as we listen to the epistle reading today. Let us be attentive.
The reading is from the first epistle of the Holy Apostle Paul to the Thessalonians.
Wisdom, let us be attentive.
Brethren, we would not have you ignorant concerning those who are asleep, that you may not grieve as others do who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Christ, God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep. For this we declare to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, shall not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a cry of a command, and with the archangel's call, and with the sound of the trumpet of God. And the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words.
Peace be with you, the reader.
And with your spirit.
Alleluia, alleluia,
alleluia.
Wisdom, arise, let us hear the holy gospel. Peace be with you all.
And with your spirit.
The holy gospel according to Saint John. Let us be attentive.
Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you.
The Lord said to those who came to him, truly, truly, I say to you, he who hears my word and believes him who sent me has eternal life and does not come into judgment, but has passed from death to life. Truly, truly, I say to you, the hour is coming and now is, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. For as the Father has life in himself, so he has granted the Son also to have life in himself, and has given him authority to execute judgment, because he is the Son of Man. Do not marvel at this, for the hour is coming, when all who are in the tombs will hear his voice and come forth, those who have done good to the resurrection of life, and those who have done evil to the resurrection of judgment. I can do nothing on my own authority. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just, because I seek not my own will, but the will of the Father who sent me.
Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you.
Ελέησον ημάς ο Θεός κατά το μέγα έλεος σου, δεόμεθά σου επάκουσον και ελέησον.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Ετι δεόμεθα υπερ αναπαύσεως της ψυχής, της και κοιμημένης δούλης του Θεού Παρθένας Πινελόπης, και υπέρ του συγχωρηθήνε αυτή πάμπλη μέλημα ακουσιόντε και ακουσιό.
Κύριε Λέησον, Κύριε Λέησον, Κύριε Λέησον.
May the Lord God grant that her soul rest with the righteous repose. Let us ask for the mercy of God, the kingdom of heaven, the forgiveness of her sins. From Christ, our immortal King and God.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God of spirits and of all flesh, you have trampled upon death and have abolished the power of the devil, giving life to your world. Give rest, O Lord, we pray, to the soul of your departed servant Penelope Parthena, in a place of light, in a place of repose, in a place of refreshment, from where pain, sorrow, and suffering have fled away. As a good and loving God, forgive every sin she has committed in thought, in word, or deed. For there is no one who lives and does not sin. You alone are without sin. Your righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and your word is truth. Του Κυρίου δεϊθόμεν.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Ότις η Ανάσταση, η ζωή και η ανάπαυση της κεκοιμημένης δούλης σου, Παρθένας Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών, και εσύ την δόξα να αναπέμπομε, συ τον Ανάρχο σου Πατρί και τον Παναγίο και αγαθό και ζωπιό σου Πνεύματι, νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Glory to you, Christ our God, and our hope, glory be to you. May Christ, our true God, who rose from the dead, and as an immortal king has authority over the living and the departed. Have mercy on us and save us through the prayers and intercessions of his spotless Holy Mother, the holy, glorious, praiseworthy apostles, our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of the holy and glorious forefathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, of his holy and righteous friend Lazarus, who lay in the grave for 4 days, and all the saints. Establish the soul of your servant Penelope Parthena, departed this life in the dwellings of the saints. Grant her rest, O Lord, in the bosom of Abraham, and number her among the righteous. Αυτός Κύριε ανάπαυσον και την ψυχή της εξ ημών μεταστάντης δούλης σου Παρθένας, εν σκηνέ δικαίων τάξε, εν κόλπης Αβραάμ αναπαύσε. Με τα δικαίων συναριθμίσε ημάς δελεήσε, ως αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος και λεήμων Θεός. Αιωνία σου η μνήμη αξιομακάριστος, αείμνηστος αδελφήμων. May your memory be eternal, dear sister, worthy of blessedness and eternal memory. Αιωνία σου η μνήμη αξιομακάριστος, αείμνηστος αδελφή ημών. Αιωνία η μνήμη, αιωνία η μνήμη, αιωνία αυτής η μνήμη, may her memory be eternal. May her memory be eternal. May her memory be eternal. Aeonia imanimi. Aeonia imanimi. Aeonia aftis imnimi. Διευκόν των Αγίων Πατέρων ημών, Κύριε Ιησού Χριστέ ο Θεός, ελέησον και σώσον ημάς.
Αμήν.
Please be seated, καθίστε παρακαλώ. There is a reality in this world that we live in that all of us are sure to experience at some stage of our life. And that, my beloved, is the death of a loved one, be it a parent, a grandparent, a sibling, a friend. And even our own death in time. Knowing then that this is so, how do we prepare ourselves for it? What thoughts pass through our mind to come to a better understanding of this reality that all of us will face in life? What better than to bring to mind the words, the very words of our Savior, who tells us, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. That is, though we all will die in the body, yet for those who believe in Christ, the soul will live with him forever in his heavenly kingdom. St. Paul, writing to the Romans regarding Christ, says, the death he died to sin once for all, but the life He lives to God. In the same way, count yourselves dead to sin, but alive to God in Christ Jesus. Penelope, whom we have gathered to remember on this day, to pray and to accompany her to her place of eternal rest, lived in that reassurance of Christ's resurrection. Those of you who knew her knew that she loved the Lord with all her heart. She would relate to me even of visions of Christ and his Holy Mother. These experiences strengthened her strengthen her faith that she continued to hope in him with all her heart. St. Peter, writing to in his epistle, writes, "Praise be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. In his great mercy, he has given us a new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Christ Jesus from the dead." Christ for Penelope was not just an idea, a theory, but a constant presence in her life. She had a special book with biblical passages and icons that she read all the time and held constantly in her arms. And I saw that it is still in her arms that she's taken with her eternally. In talking to family and friends, Penelope was described to me once again as an individual with a happy, a joyful demeanor. She always had a big smile on her face. One of her greatest loves was to make others happy through her cooking. She was an excellent chef. She was the proprietor of Penelope's Bistro in Walton Hills for many years. And she would tell me of all those individuals who passed through her restaurant, how much love they had for her. But she also loved them equally and served them all with much joy. Through the years, she helped many people here in Greece. She never hesitated to offer assistance in whatever way she could. And in many ways, we can reflect and say this was her downfall. She helped so many, but she was not able to help herself. She was proud of her Hellenic heritage, all the customs and all that, and especially she was proud of her Pontian roots, where her loved ones came from in Asia Minor. When the ladies of our parish came together to prepare for our annual food festival, oftentimes you would see Penelope there by their side helping them. They remember her joyful attitude and her willingness to help in any way she could. In fact, when she was in the kitchen working, she was a powerhouse of energy to be reckoned with because she was doing what she loved the most. She would tell me of her dreams to appear on television on cooking shows and there to promote her books, her cookbooks that she had published. She was often sad in relating these stories because they did not come to fruition. Our Philoptochos had a bake sale just a few weeks ago, the end of October, and she was there and she also bought sweetbread to give to her doctors as a thank you. She loved her daughters very much. Pamela is here today with us, and her other daughter, Rula, who lives in Greece. And I hope she's watching live today on the live stream from there. She also had two grandkids, Anastasia, who is in Greece, and Nicholas, who is with us today. I saw Penelope on Sunday, this past Sunday after church. And she was again very lively, even though you could tell in a visible way that she was deteriorating. She had a little oxygen thing on her nose to help her, but you could see her energy and her vitality. It was also very obvious that cancer was spreading very quickly. And she wanted so desperately to receive Holy Communion, for the church to offer prayers for her, and in many ways to prepare her for this transition from this life to the next eternal life. She was at peace and more joyful she was because her daughter Pamela was by her side.
I thank Steve also for his kindness in allowing Penelope dignity these last days of her life. Thank you to our dear Philoptos ladies for reaching out to her always with kindness to remind her that she was loved and remembered. And thank you to all who have and will continue to contribute to make this Christian burial a reality for our dear Penelope. In closing, my dear friends, we get a small glimpse into the unfathomable love the Lord has for each and every one of us, of his children, especially when we read these words from John. Father, the Lord says, Father, I want those whom you have given me to be with me where I am and to see my glory, the glory which you have given to me because you loved me before the creation of the world. To be with me in a place where St. Paul describes there is so much beauty. Eye has not seen, St. Paul says, nor ear has heard, nor have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who love him. A special place where we will not taste any longer what this imperfect world has to offer. No more pain, no more suffering, and no more imperfect relationships, but an eternal, peaceful life in the presence of our Heavenly Father. Yes, my beloved, death is one reality that all of us will experience at some point of our life. And we do so, as we read in the epistle lesson today, not like those who have no hope. For our hope is in our resurrected Lord and Savior. To her family and loved ones, we extend our sympathy and love. And we pray that Almighty God may have mercy and grant eternal rest to our beloved sister. Amen. Ο Θεός να την αναπαύει και να χαρίσει κουράγιον, άνωθεν δύναμη και παρηγορία στα τέκνα, στα εγγόνια, στους συγγενείς εδώ και από την Ελλάδα. Ο Θεός να την αναπαύει. The funeral directors will come forth at this time. They will guide you starting from the back to come forth and offer your last respect. May Almighty God give you kiss to your sister. Amen.
Τελευταίον ασπασμό. Δώμε αδελφοί τη θανούση ευχαριστούντες Θεόν ου αυτή γάρε ξελείπε τη συγγενείας αυτής και προς τα φωνε πηγαίνεται, που και τη φροντίζω, τα της ματαιότητος και πολυμόχθους αρκός, που νη συγγενείστε και φίλοι, άρτη χωρίζομεθα υπέρ, αναπαύσε Κύριος ευξόμεθα. Brethren, what at this last moment means. Your distress of parting and wailing, what means your funeral dirge? Come and give a kiss to her so lately with us. For conceived in the grave, darkness has covered her where the dead are entombed. Come, all you, her kindred and comrades, now come the hour of parting. Let us pray to the Lord to bring her eternal rest.
Agios ο Θεός, Αγίος ισχύος, Αγίος αθάνατος,
mercy.
Misha last night. Did you forget? I forgot to remember. You know what happened? I prepared, and I was working on it on Wednesday. I had all these wonderful things. I must have forgot to save it. So then I had a funeral. I had to go to another funeral yesterday morning.
Oh my gosh.
And so I came back yesterday. I opened my computer, and nothing was there.
Oh, Father,
so I had to like quickly put together. Thank God everything went okay, but. Up so bad with that. And I just, yeah. Anyway.
I appreciate every time you can go by. Thank you.
Oh,
my intention is my brain is in some place.
No problem.
God bless you. Have a good day.
You too. You too.
Hey, Mark. Have a blessed day.
Okay, bye, Lee.